Hello, Serge here from the back porch. We have a clipboard out again today, so we have a question. And this is from Hydro Dan. And Dan says, I'm new to golf and I was thinking about wearing a glove. If I do, would there be any specific areas on the palm that would show signs of wear if I'm gripping the club right? Thank you, Dan. Well, that's a really good question, Dan. And because I think a lot of people often say that, I wear gloves out really too fast. So normally what I would say to that is that the gloves will wear out if there is friction. I mean, all gloves will eventually wear out, but they'll wear out a lot quicker if there is friction. And friction would mean that somewhere along the line, the club is moving in your hand, so that the grip, especially being rubber against leather gloves, even some synthetics might last a little bit longer, but with leather, will start to wear it out. Friction is what's wearing it out. So the question becomes, what's causing the friction? I think probably the number one points to look at would be a incorrect grip. Sometimes if we hold the club too much in the palms of our hand, it could slide around, especially on missed hits. And again, I'm going to go down a record here saying that even one, if you have correct grip pressure and a correct grip size, if you hit them badly enough on the toe or the heel, you very likely still could have twisting of the club in your hands. The second point would be, if the grip is incorrect because it's too much in the palms, you could have slipping, because when you wrap it around in your palms, it's not a very tight forming grip in the hands, because the grip should be held more in the fingers. If your grip is the wrong size, especially too small, you'd have to try to squeeze tighter to hold it, but again, it could slip in your hands. So we got those three concepts of the grip. Then the last big thing about grip would be grip pressure. Long-time history of golf instruction talking about grip pressure is to hold it like a baby bird. Hold it like you have an open tube of toothpaste. You don't want to squeeze any out. Hold it, you know, softly, and you don't want tension. Well, yeah, I don't want tension, but you have to have enough grip pressure to hold it. I've seen many, many lessons where I've asked a student, I can just look at them and I see that they're not holding a club, and I'd say, take your grip and hold the club up in the air, because I want to grab the club from you, and they just stand there, and I can just twist it in their hands like this, or pull it right out of their hands. And I say, heck, you know, I mean, if I had a pencil here, most of you would hold a pencil firmer to write your name. How about if you played basketball or you played tennis with two-handed tennis? I mean, do you hold it as light as you've been told to hold a golf club? I don't think so. So I think we got to get into a good firm grip pressure. So those are the main issues of why a grip would wear out. Now, here I have three gloves in my pocket. The first one here will be a glove that I've been wearing for a very, very long time. Probably have played, it's been in my bag months, and probably have played at least, you know, two dozen 9-hole rounds with it, and maybe a couple 18s. And you'll see here, looking at this glove, that there are no wear marks on it. Normally a glove will you'll get some wear on the heel pad over here or on the thumb pad. And this one's not showing, as very little here on the heel pad. And this is just a all leather golf glove, and I'm not showing any wear hardly at all. And I mean, you can see from the outsides of the glove, it's getting quite dirty, it's getting a little cracked on it, but no wear marks, because I have a good grip and I use a relatively firm grip pressure. If you did, between one being holding it like a dead fish and five squeezing it till you almost pop your eyeballs out, I'm about a three, right in the middle, a good formal business person handshake. Okay, now let's look at my second glove. I've played a lot less with this glove, but it is still a leather glove, and it is showing signs of wear. Again, it's worn out on the fingertips a little bit. It's showing wear, but I have a mark here on the heel pad that's starting to show some wear, and I have one on the thumb, but they have not broken through yet. I've worn this glove to play quite a bit, and again, it's starting to show wear, but I'll bet you it's been in my bag probably close to 6 months now. I mean, I don't play as much as I'd like to, but it's here. We have wear on the heel pad, and we have wear a little bit on the thumb, but they have not, you know, created a hole yet. Again, been in the bag quite a while, and I've played quite a few rounds of golf with it. All right, now the last glove we're going to look at is a relatively new glove. This one is I just put it in the bag, and I think I've only worn it once for nine holes, or maybe two at the most. And you can see this one's basically brand new, except it got a little dirty here in the thumb. I must have had a dirty grip or something when I grabbed it, but it's showing nowhere anywhere on the heel pad or the thumb. So gloves should last fairly long if you take care of them. They recommend you put them back in the package you got them in. For the most part, once I take it out of the package, I just usually fold them up and put them in my bag. And if it was hot and I sweat a lot, I'd probably hang it out on the outside of the bag to dry up. Or if it got wet and around because of a little rain or whatever, I'd leave it on the outside of the bag to dry up. But gloves will last if you have the proper grip size and a good grip pressure to make sure that, and lastly, that you hold it firmly enough that the club won't just slip in your hands, and your gloves should last. Why do you use a glove? Many people use it because they feel they got a better grip on the club. And so for Dan, if you haven't really used gloves or not or whatever, you need to try them and make up your mind if you feel like you grip it better with a glove or without. And that's just a personal preference. Most golfers will say they definitely have a better grip on the club when they wear a glove. And especially many golfers who perspire a lot, especially in the summer, feel that they got a better grip. And I've seen some of them have three and four gloves that they hang out on a cart or on their bag. Like every other hole, they change one and they put it back on until it gets wet, and they go to the one they've dried up. So you need to find out for yourself if you like it. But I think when you see how many people wear them, I think it's a pretty good safe bet that for the most part, most people grip the club better with a golf club. Well, that's it for the search for today on the back porch about golf gloves and golf clubs and having a better grip on it. So I'll be talking to y'all again soon.